हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिसेस शबनू नवाज फ्रॉम होली हार्ट्स एजुकेशनल अकेडमी रायपुर छत्तीसगढ़ एंड टुडे आई एम हियर टू टेक द क्लासेस ऑफ क्लास 12 स्टूडेंट्स एंड द टॉपिक एज वी हैव प्रीवियसली कवर्ड द नेटवर्किंग टॉपिक्स फ्यू टॉपिक्स आर लेफ्ट दैट विल स्टार्ट टुडे सो लेट्स स्टार्ट
स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर डीलिंग हियर विद फ्यू टॉपिक्स ऑफ नेटवर्किंग दैट इज मोबाइल कंप्यूटिंग टेक्नोलॉजीज एंड The topics that today in this session we'll cover is GSM, CDMA, GPRS, various generations, SMS, chat, Wi-Fi and WiMAX. Next, if we see what is GSM? GSM means Global System for Mobile Communication. The GSM basically uses the narrowband TDMA which allows 8 simultaneous calls on the same radio frequencies. Now, what is TDMA? TDMA is actually a time division multiple access. That is a technology used for delivering the digital wireless services using the time division multiplexing. That is TDM. So, it works on dividing a radio frequencies into a time slots and then allocating the slots to multiple calls. In this way, a single frequency can support multiple simultaneous data channels. So, we can say here that GSM digitizes and compresses the voice data. Then sends it down a channel with other streams of user data, each in its own time slots. So the GSM system uses encryptions to make the phone calls more secure and it operates on about 900 megahertz and 1800 megahertz bands in Europe and Asia and many more different things. Next, if we deal with is CDMA. CDMA, by the name itself, it is clear it is code division multiple access and it is again a digital cellular technology that uses a spread spectrum technique. Now, what is spread spectrum technique? Actually, unlike to the GSM system, we can say that the GSM as uses TDMA, the CDMA does not use a specific frequency for other users or each of the users. Instead, it uses a channel, uses the full available spectrum over there. Hence, the CDMA is, we can say it is a form of a spread spectrum, which simply means that data is sent in small pieces over a number of discrete frequencies available there at that particular time range. So, the CDMA, in short, if we say CDMA uses a spread spectrum technique where data is sent in small pieces over a number of discrete frequencies. Hence, each user's signals is spread over the entire bandwidth by unique spreading code at the receiver end. Again, the same unique code is used to recover that particular signal. So this is the working of CDMA. Next, if we deal with is GPRS. The full form of GPRS is General Packet Radio Service, and it is actually a technology for the radio transmission of small packets of data, especially between the mobile devices and the internet, and many more things. We all know that the various packets are broken, datas are broken into a small packets and then sent across from the sender to the recipient, that we are studying from very lower classes. Next is the various generations. If we deal with is, so here if you see with the various generations, the first generation is an analog technology. And here the phone had a very poor battery life and the voice quality was also not good, not much more secure. So then the upgradation was done for second generation. And here in the second generation, as compared to first generation, the radio signals of first generations were in analog, while in second generation networks were digital. Now next, moving towards third generation, various techniques like or technologies, we can say like web browsing, video downloading, picture sharing, mailings, and the different other smartphone technologies were introduced in third generation. Similarly, if we deal with fourth generation, the purpose of fourth generation is basically a high speed and high quality, a high capacity to the user while improving the security and lower the cost of voice and data services. Next on, moving towards the fifth generation, it improves the fourth generation, and the fifth generation again promises much more faster data rates and the higher connection densities, much lower latencies among the other improvements. So in summarized way, if we see all the other generations are introduced as the improvement of its prior generation. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज SMS. SMS, एज वी ऑल नो, SMS स्टैंड्स फॉर शॉर्ट मैसेज सर्विस. एंड SMS इज एक्चुअली अ मैसेजिंग टेक्निक, वी कैन से, और अ टेक्स्ट मैसेजिंग टेक्निक, और वी कैन से अ ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ अ शॉर्ट टेक्स्ट मैसेजेस फ्रॉम और टू द एनी ऑफ द मोबाइल फोन्स. वंस द मोबाइल, सॉरी, मैसेजेस आर सेंट फ्रॉम द मोबाइल, दे आर रीच टू द SMS centers, and from that centers they are sent to the appropriate destination. Next is chat. Chat, as we all know, the term chat, by the name itself it is very much clear, chatting is a very friendly term or a very casual conversation term. So we can tell it as an online textual talk in a real time form. So this is what chatting. Next is Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi, we all know the full form of Wi-Fi is wireless fidelity. It helps us to connect to the internet without a direct line from your PC to the ISP, that is the internet service provider. So Wi-Fi here allows all of us to have an interaction with the internet and allows various devices to exchange the informations from one to the other networks. Next is WiMAX. WiMAX is again a different wireless digital communication system, and it provides a broadband wireless access up to 30 miles for a fixed stations. It requires a small towers like WiMAX base stations, we can say, like similar to the cell phone towers, which are connected to the internet using a standard wired high speed connections. So these were the topics that we have to deal today. And here are few assignments, students, that you need to do it in your CS notes copies. First is prepare short notes on all the topics that we have covered in the video. As you all know that it is not possible to go to in a detailed way to any of the topic in this particular online video. So whenever the school reopens, just chalk out all your doubts so that when the school opens, we can go through your doubts and clear your doubts so that the particular topic is prepared for the further exams. Next question is explain GSM and CDMA. These are the two questions based on this particular video that you need to do it in your CS notes copies, which will be checked when the school reopens.
Students, we have seen few topics of networking, and so I hope you all understood very well. Go through the video, listen it carefully, go through the contents and follow the instructions given, and complete the assignments in your computer notes copies. By that time, stay safe, stay at home. Thank you.